Hi there. In this video, we're going to talk about logic in everyday life. So let's start with the smallest piece or basic building blocks. So we're going to start with a single statement, which is called a proposition. A proposition is a statement that makes a claim. Okay, and the statement that makes a claim must be a complete sentence. So it can't be a phrase and it can't be a question, anything like that. So let's write that down. Okay, so it has to be a complete sentence. So here's a couple examples. Anka is sitting on the table. Is that a proposition? That is a statement, and yes, it's making a claim. We don't know if it's true or not, but she is sitting on the table. So yes, this is a proposition. What about where are you going after class? So is that making a claim? No, it's asking a question. So it's not a proposition. It's not something that we could say is true or false because it's a question. Okay, so as I kind of alluded to, a proposition has two possible truth values. It could be true or false. Okay, so we could have a false claim, right? There's nothing saying that a proposition has to be true, but we would want to identify often whether things are true or false. Okay, so that's kind of just one statement, and then we're going to be doing more things to the statements, putting them together, even making arguments out of them. Okay, so one thing we could do is a negation. You're probably very familiar with this. So a negation of a proposition makes the opposite claim. It's switching the meaning to the opposite meaning. That's making the opposite claim. Okay, so taking the same one for A, write a negation. Anka is sitting on the table, so I could say Anka is not. Sitting on the table. Okay, and now we have a different one, the dog, because this is a proposition. The dog is not in the backyard. So it's already in the negative, so to negate that, we would make it go the other way. The dog is in the backyard. Okay, and now you're also probably familiar with a double negative or double negation. For example, we could have said the dog is not in the backyard, right? To switch the meaning to the dog is in the backyard. So a double negation has two negatives, or when a negated proposition is itself negated. So let's turn each of these into a double negation. I will not wash my hands, okay? So now if I could, you know, turn that into the reverse by saying I will wash my hands, but then that's not a double negative. So I'm going to say, I will not wash my hands. And there can be many ways to say these sometimes. So you could put in won't, I won't not wash my hands. In this one, it says the original is, it is unlikely that there is an association. So I could say it is not unlikely, and then that's like two negatives, right? Because it's unlikely, so not unlikely. Or I could say it's unlikely that there is not an association. So I could also put it right there. And I bet you could even think of another way to do it. So I'm going to write the first way. It is not unlikely that there is an association. We could also make this into a triple negative if we said it is not unlikely that there is not an association. And then it starts getting really confusing, right? So while technically this I will not wash my hands means the same as I will wash my hands, I think sometimes we do this for emphasis, or to have a, sometimes we do mean it to have a slightly different meaning. So I think we might use a double negative for emphasis. Or for example, if someone says they're not wrong, we might say that because we're thinking, well, they're not, I don't agree with them completely, but they have a point, so they're not wrong. So sometimes a double negation does mean a slightly different thing than the statement without, same statement without any negation at all. Okay, so this is a negation. This is something you're doing on one proposition, a single statement. But we also might want to put different statements together. And so to do that, we use logical connectors. Okay, so some connectors, I'm sure you're familiar with these. You've heard of and, or, and then another one is if then. So these connect two or more, whereas the negation is working on a single statement. These connect two or more separate propositions into a single statement. Okay, so a couple examples. Ramesh has a cat and Ramesh has a dog. So here's two different propositions. Again, each could be true or false. Ramesh has a cat and Ramesh has a dog. Now this is, I put it like this to emphasize these are two separate propositions. But often we would do a little shortcut like I did on the second one. Ramesh has a cat or a dog. We wouldn't usually repeat the person's name if we were speaking that. But so this is a shortcut, but with an or. I could have said Ramesh has a cat or Ramesh has a dog, right? Okay, so then in an if-then statement, we have the if part and then the then part. So if Ramesh has a cat, then usually we're saying something will happen if the if condition is met. So if Ramesh has a cat, then Ramesh will get a dog. So that's a possible statement there. Okay, thanks for watching, and we'll go into more detail on these in the next videos. I'll see you there.